jerseys.
Clock was at 4.3. So they stopped play, but the clock did run, I think, properly. Because it's on the catch.
They didn't want to do anything. And they need him, obviously. They are still 2 wins away from securing back-to-back 500 seasons, at least 500. That hasn't happened since 2004 and 5.
A long time. He's headed to the sideline. Precaution, I'm sure. Anderson replaces him.
Not quite halfway through the quarter. Connelly, tough shot. Foul, count it.
Jerseys may hold them to fewer than 100 tonight, 105-94.
Yeah, you're going to use a little clock here.
Make sure you get a good shot.
Yeah, under 5 seconds.
Brooks for three. Bingo! Nail, coffin, this baby's over. Boone, boarded by Brooks. San Antonio. And Ty Blue and Taylor Jenkins are bracing with 20 seconds remaining in the game.
What this is.
Yeah, we're done here. Shot clock violation forthcoming. And the Grizzlies 101, Clippers 94.
That's what had it. And the Denver play last night. This is the Grizzlies to 2.5.
Grizzlies against Sacramento is taking on Portland tonight. 108-94 is your final. And
3 points, 14 rebounds, 32 minutes.
Doing it. I just love the way the Lakers defense is playing.
Yeah, it's turned this thing around.
Yeah,
180 degrees.
The difference has strictly been the intensity on the defensive side. And get another look at Anthony Davis just controlling the glass. No Gobert in there, and Anthony Davis says it doesn't matter. Then he brings it down and goes against the big cat. I mean, he's just been dominant again on a one bad wheel.
I mean, these Laker players, they know that they have a makeup on this roster. If things go their way here late in the year, they can make a run. Deep, AD was talking all about it. They want to get in. They want to get comfortable. They want this W, 108-94.
The Anthony Davis Offensive Show.
As we enter the final five, brought to you by Morongo Casino Resort and Spa.
Turned back by Ivy, stays with it. Found some room and got bumped and got fouled and will go to the line. Defense right there, but the Rockets got to work on their spacing, man. Standing right on top of each other. Jalen Green just playing the angle. Sure, during the draft, I was working out for Memphis, and Jerry West came over and just went right over my head. He said, son, if you just could learn the angles of basketball. And I'm like, Jerry West, I didn't, you know, take trigonometry, man. I didn't pass it. I don't know what you're talking about, angles of basketball, but understanding the angles. Now you've got the proper angles so you can get downhill and move your guys. A couple of former Rockets have really understood angles well. Chris Paul and James Harden.
Yes.
Jalen Green's missed 5 free throws tonight. He's been there a lot, 13 times. He's 8 of 13 though at the line. AJ Jones stepping back and hitting the two. And we talked a lot about the little things that the Rockets did not do well in Brooklyn that ultimately added up to a loss. Now, them raining threes down like crazy in the fourth quarter with a 9-3 certainly was the biggest reason why the Nets won the game. But the little things add up. Here's Smith. Three ball. No. Back tap by Clark. To Porter. To Smith. Another try out. No. Same result. And then on the ensuing rebound, Shingun got fouled.
Yeah, Wiseman got Rose's wrap out here around the head. But you like this. Rockets struggling to shoot. What are they doing? They are working these boards. And that is the efficiency of the Rockets.
Man, that was Wiseman's. Wiseman's sixth. He just fouled out. Pistons over the foul limit. Wiseman's done.
That's the respect for Al P here. Watch Wiseman. He just wraps Al P. But go get nasty, man. Go hit those boards. And we talk about the controllables. And Al P quite aware of saying, guys, hey,
he's officially out of the game. Durant picks him up. He's playing with four.
That, you see the dominance of Al P here tonight. All his matchups are in foul trouble, man. Well, Rui's going to have to guard him pretty soon, Craig.
3:48 to go. Rockets have been only called for a couple of team fouls so far in the period. So from that perspective, they look like they're in good shape. As I said, Pistons over the limit. One more free throw here for Shingun. Rockets, this is their 36th attempt at the line in this game. Detroit's only attempted 19. Shingun is 4-4 at the strike. And it will be Dwayne Casey and the Pistons calling a timeout here. It's a one possession game. 3:48 to go.
From the very start, he's been aggressive, but it seemed like when he sustained the ankle injury, he got even more aggressive. He has been the catalyst on semi both ends of the floor, but especially on the offensive end, where he has just taken the tools and surgically dissected them.
Stu, AD, 11 of the last 13 Laker points. Lakers have outscored the Wolves in the second half, 53-29, in front of a sold-out crowd. And tickets were in such demand, they took the tarp off in the upper deck behind the baskets. They had that up the entire year.
When the Lakers show up, you know the ticket sales are going to go up.
That's right. They took that tarp down. 108-95. By the way, our crew here tonight, our traveling crew, Marshawn, the Dubba, Maddie, Antony, and Evans. By the way, Antony gets the gold medal tonight for getting us on the air audio-wise.
He gets the gold medal for every night.
Does. And the great local crew here. It's nice to change anybody who goes works here in the Twin Cities. Love having him. AD flies in, and again, that's a good find by D'Lo.
Laker guards of D'Lo and Schroeder making that play routine.
Back to 14. Connelly, kind of it goes.
Oh, this one is close. Dennis is bleeding.